Hey everyone. Hey, this is Shoshana. There we go. We've got people coming in. Okay, I am at a Starbucks. I am Shoshana Kliski. Let's see if I can turn this around. The lighting in here is horrendous. Get ready. Well, welcome. Look at the lighting. I've got funny coloring. So, I'm Shoshana Kliski. I am here at Starbucks. Yay. Cheers. We're going to have coffee together. How's that sound? So talk to me, you guys. Tell me where you're from. And my title is, hey, how you doing? My title is, I love you too. My title is, do-it-yourself metalsmithing studio, let's talk hammers. Look at me. I am like wild. My hair is wild. I have had a wild day today. I had to work on my Porsche. I have a Porsche, a vintage Porsche. And the Porsche was, oh, yay, Illinois. And the Porsche's not starting. Well, hello, Manchester City. Oh, Ginger, you're on. Welcome. Hey, you can sit in your daughter's house. You move back north. And I can sit in a Starbucks in California, Ginger, and we'll have coffee together. How's that sound? Red cup. Russia. Woohoo. You guys, I am wild. My eyes are wild. Everything's wild. I have this Porsche, vintage Porsche, in my garage. And I wanted to move it out so I could do some work on the shop. India's here. Oh, tea and coffee. Cheers. And it wouldn't start. Now, I'm not a car buff. But I know enough to know that I have to do Hello Mexico. Enough stuff to try and get it started. So, of course, I pop the hood. But it's oil. It's oil cooled. So, it's not like every other car. So, hi. Smiling. So, that's why I've got the wild eyes and the wild hair. I have been under the hood of a Porsche. I wanted to be working on my jewelry stuff. I wanted to be streaming from my jewelry bench. I've got it all set. I wanted to show you my waxes, and it's like, no. So I decided to get away and get some coffee at Starbucks. So tell me, you guys. I know Ginger's in here. And Ginger, I was thinking of this scope title because of Drenis. You know how he said to you that he's dressing hammers? So I figured, let's talk hammers. I know. Wait till you see it. I've got this bench, and it's set up for do-it-yourself metalsmithing. It's not like yours, and it's not like Andrew's. And it's like, yes. So, let's talk dressing hammers. I know he'll get on at some point. You like me? I like you too. I know, it'll be fun. It's going to be fun. I'm going to have this makeshift shop for everybody like Drenis, who is starting off, and they don't have all the equipment. Well, that's actually where I came up with the, yay, Drenis. Do you want me to call you Neil? I'll call you Neil. Neil Warrior. This scope, cheers, is for you. And Ginger's on here. Ginger is a professional. She is a master at everything she does. Master goldsmith, jeweler. Put up some emojis. Ginger, so that people can follow you. She can also give tips on dressing and hammer. So I was thinking, hey, I don't look sexy. Look at this hair. I look wild tonight. I know, by hand. That's what got me going. That's why I did this little title. Okay, so Drenis. Do you want me to call you Neo or Drenis? Oh, yay. Lobe Dangles here. What a cool name. All right, so who's thinking driving over here is loving life right now, enjoying. I know. So do you want me to call you Neo? I'm going to call you Neo. I'll call you Neo. Ah, hi. Okay, so what would I do if I had to, if I got a hammer, I am doing good, and I saw there were dings and scratches in the I'm just going to use layman's terms. I'm not going to talk real jewelry. I'm going to leave that up to Andrew, Ginger, Mother on the Mountain, Kelly, all those people. So what would I do if I got a hammer? And I looked at the head of the hammer, and I saw there was a great big scratch. Pretend this is the head, and I saw a scratch. How would I dress it? How would I clean it up? How would I do the filing down and things if I did not have a file, not have a buffing machine or a Dremel of any sort to grind it down or a grinding? Hey, Miss Ole, is that what I call you? Ole? Cheers. So I started thinking. Okay, so a DIY, hey, hola, ole. I would think, okay, cement could do it. I am very young. I'm 5. I would use a brick. I would use, what was the question? The question is this. I thought of you when you were talking to Ginger about dressing your hammer. And if I wanted to file the head of a, if I wanted to polish the head of my new hammer that I got because I had some dings in it or something, and I didn't have a file or a buffing wheel or a grinding wheel or anything like that, I'm in Northern California. What would I use? So, this is what I would use. I thought of all these ideas. And Ginger, jump in. Okay. I would look for a brick, so I'd go and see if there was any, yeah, rough to silky. I would find a brick, and I would put the brick down, and I would take my hammer, and I would gently scrape it. I would make sure that it wasn't putting deeper cuts. Hello, I don't speak Spanish. I would make sure that I would go across the brick very gently, hi. And then I would look at it, and I'd move my hammer in the light. I would move it to see what's scraping off. Hi, yay, we have Yeshina. I always want to say Yesina. So I would look, I would move my hammer in the light like this. Malaysia's here. I would, a kiln brick would also work. Cement would also work. Yes, a ceramic stone would also work. Like, I know that Drenis has a couple things. I would, very good. I would think the bottom, I sharpen a lot of my knives, you know, in the, when I'm sharpening, there are these blades that you can sharpen on, or these stones, the knife sharpening stones. I would use those. Hello, Mexico. I would use the bottom. I've used this to sharpen up my bricks and my knives and my hammers. The bottom of a bowl. Arkansas stone, absolutely. And if you go and you have a ceramic bowl that you eat out of and you turn upside down, the ceramic that does not have any of the glaze on it, that's a very, it also makes it so it can sharpen it or sand it down. But I have to tell you, hello, welcome. If you could speak English, that'd be great. That the key to this, using non-flat surfaces like maybe a ceramic bowl bottom or a brick, is that you do scraping a little bit, you look very quickly and just keep looking. Just, you cannot look enough. Ginger will tell you that the key is to keep looking at the surface that you're finishing. So you do a little bit, you look at it, you fix it, you look at it, you turn it again, and you keep looking at it. And you start with the coarse thing first. So if you have like a fire brick, not a fire brick, just a regular brick, like a red brick, and then you go down to a white brick. Hello. And you grind it. Make sure that the cuts or the That's it. Hello. And I got all excited when you were saying, and then I saw your Instagram. Did you see my comment on your Instagram? Rockstar metalsmithing. Yee-hoo. Oh, they always, I am known for getting interrupted all the time. It's like you're there watching so closely. I know. Absolutely. I really got excited about, he's got this hammer and he's finishing the top. Well, when he gets his files and other buffing like tools, like a grinding wheel and all the other things, that'll make it go faster. But the whole idea is the same thing. You look at how deep are the scratches on the head of your hammer, and you decide what are you going to start with. And are you going to grind? You don't want something that grinds deeper than the scratch that you have. You want to have it be a little bit less than the scratch that you have. And if it's just thin scratches, then you go right to sandpaper and you just work. Hello, how are you? 30 minutes. Good for you. And the cool thing about this, I know, the cool thing about this is that you can do it with any of your metal tools. That's what I said. No way. You can do it to your pliers because they're made out of metal. Some of your pliers have metal little thingies. And you can do it with your stakes. You can do it with your, I'm drawing a blank on all them. I see them in my head, guys, the ring shanks. You can do it on bracelet shanks. The same thing. It's just that this is when you start off rough. It's usually when it has a deep cut. Yeah, it wasn't bad. I watched him. Oh, good. Yeah. Now, here's what I would then do next. And Ginger, you put in your two bits. Mandrels, very good. Hear, hear to mandrels. I'm excited. I really wanted to be scoping on my bench today. In fact, I threw a tizzy fit. I was so angry because my Porsche, and yes, it's a luxury problem. I call it a luxury problem. Did not start, so I couldn't move it. I have to move it to the other side because I have, it just has to move, and I haven't been able to get it moved. Anyways, what I like doing is when I'm on the bench and I'm using my tools, and you know, when you're working really close, after a while, your eyes get really good at looking very close. I don't use the visors. My eyes are still pretty good at looking up really, really close. And what I'll see is I'll be working, I'll see my tools will have a little hairline scratch, and it just like, it will go onto my metal, and it bothers me. So I have this very fine, Ginger, you know what I'm talking about. It's a cloth. It's almost like an emery cloth, very, very fine. Lucky me. Yes, I was blessed with really good eyesight. These are new. Good eyes. And so it's a cloth sandpaper that is so fine that if I were to go across my fingernail, it would not make it matte looking. It would shine it. And where I got this trick was, you know how women go in and they have these buffers over their fingernails to bring it to eye shine? I went in and I bought the same material that they use for the buffing their fingernails, and I just keep touching up my tools when I'm working so that I never have to go back and dress my tools, because I'm finicky about what I put on my metal, because I just like making sure. I don't know, that's just me. Some people like chunky looks, and I love chunky looks. I like shiny looks. And so, has anybody ever tried those buffers for your fingernails that brings it to eye shine on your tools? They work like a charm. I love them. Tell me, has anybody tried that? Another thing I do, you like shiny too. Yay, Cheryl, you're here. Oh, you're a different Cheryl. Is that oil? And I have to be careful when I tell people this, but peppermint oil. Yes. Some people use nail files. I don't use nail files. I use the easier to keep good finish. Yes. Is that I don't like rust getting, like, since I have a bunch of different tools, the disposable. Some of them have little ridges on the side, so you kind of have to look at the tools that you're going to put on your tools, emery boards, and make sure those edges are not sticking up higher because they're stamped out. They've got these little edges, so you kind of like grind them down so they're easier to use. Is that I like using peppermint oil, nylons, and some kind of backing on those two, and I like working that way on my tools, and then I can clean them off. But peppermint oil can actually cause burning of your skin and so forth. Another thing I like to do is that they call them dry erasers, and they are ground up erasers inside of a bag, a really soft cotton bag. And on my steaks, I take those dry erasers. Some people used to use them to do blinds and so forth, but they're for drafting. You know, when you're drafting, you have this little bag of crumbled up eraser. And I use that on my steaks because that keeps the rust away. And I put that on my mandrels and so forth. And I do it like once a week or something. Another thing to keep the rust off, because it's tool steel, and all these tools, if it's raining out or it's moist and you don't have a dehumidifier, are going to get rusty after a while if you don't use them. And so what I tend to do is that I put a lot of those, you know, you can get these, I don't know what they call them, but in some of our pill jars, our vitamin jars, they have those little packets of drying agent. So I save them all and I just throw them in my drawers, and it helps. A little bit counts. So tell me. Yeah. So I throw them in anything that's going to hold my tools, like my drawers, or if I have these things that close up my hammers and things like that, and then just to keep them protected from the rust. Some people, now Ginger, please tell me how you do it. What I do, if I have to storm and move or something, is that I take wax paper and soak it in 3-in-1 oil, and I put it right over all my tools and just lather them up with the oil. And then when I get to the place and destination, because I've wrapped them in newspaper then I take all that stuff off, wipe it down with a nice soft cloth, and it starts again. So there's my two bits. So tell me, you guys, I've got this itch. Tell me about your hammers. You fixed the leaking ceiling? Oh, you did? Oh, yay. That was a pain. I bet you that would have made me frustrated. That would have made me very frustrated. Here in California, we don't have that right now. And so I don't have to worry too much about rusting from the moisture. But how did you fix it? Did you guys have to, your tool bag is getting heavier? Oh, yay. Yes. Dennis, tell me what tools you have. I know what tools you have, but tell Ginger some of the tools you have. And Ginger, how did you fix your ceiling? Did you find the leak was going in your roof and then draining down someplace else and leaking in, or how did you fix it? You made your husband do it. How did he fix it, though? Oh. And you pointed. I like that. I like that very much. Yay. What tea are you drinking, Ginger? So, Drenis, tell me your favorite. Hello from Brazil. If you could speak English, that would be so helpful for me. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you for the hearts, you guys. And thank you for joining in. I wanted to scope earlier. I wanted to scope about 10 hours ago. Oh, yay. Everybody's joining on and off. So, Ginger, tell me. There was something I wanted to ask you. Oh, that business thing that you're going to? I'm jealous. I want to be there. What are you doing? I've watched every stream. Why do I ask? I love coffee. I love tea. I love Earl Grey. But I'm always amazed how much tea you drink. It's almost like you have a little bit of UK in you. So I want to know, what is this cool thing you're doing? When I woke up today early in the morning and then I checked your... You love tea. I have one daughter that loves tea. Wow. Welcome. Let's see, your name is Z Huns. Welcome. I'm Shoshana Kaliski, and I am from Northern California. And where we were talking about, I've worked in the jewelry studio. It's your business mastermind. Oh, I wish I could do that. I want to be doing that. Yay, you're from Kazakhstan too. Oh, man, I want to do that. I love doing stuff like that. Let's see if I can say his name, her name. Zahan Seya. Wow. Is Terry here? No way. I didn't even see that he got on. I really wish I could go to that. Those kind of things, they inspire me so much. Hey, Terry. We're talking about how to dress hammers. You put little tutus on them, like Andrew says. No, I was talking about, what do you do if you don't have the tools, the electronics, to clean them up? Chasing hammer, textured hammer, tweezers, saw, visor, copper, pliers, different kinds, torch, and butane torch. A butane torch and another kind of torch. Cool. Steel block. Dennis is so excited about his tools. Ginger, remember when we first got our tools? Man, I was drooling every time I got something new. I had this little teeny plumber's torch. No kidding. I know, isn't this so cool? People are gifting. Yes. And so remember, Ginger, when we used to get our tools? It took me years. It did not take me years. Your favorite scoper's on here. Yay! Loving it. It's so amazing. I was lucky. I just was born into it. So they had a jewelry studio, and I said, this is what I need, blah, 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 blah. They bought the stuff, and I got to teach, and I got to do all this stuff. But I got to hang out with all the people that didn't get to do that. And what I find really fun is mugshot. I like the mugshot. So we had a jewelry studio. I remember I'd get one or two things at a time. Oh, man, that would drive me nuts. See, that is what my friends would do. They would get one or two things at a time, and then they would look at me, and we'd have a big fat studio, jewelry store, and they'd be drooling. And so I didn't, what I wanted, hey, I'm going to sneeze. Sorry, you're giving Terry a nickname. Terry is the mugshot. Costa Rica, welcome. I am Shoshana. We're from Northern California. We're jewelers, artists, and we're talking about stuff, getting tools and stuff. Oh, the guys should do my heart and him. You should do that. You know, if you go on to, what is it called? It's a 3D printing place. What is it called? Is Stitch and Blade on here? Stitch and Blade knows about this 3D printing Shapeways. Go to shapeways.com. Everybody on here, go to shapeways.com. You can go, it's like heart-shaped ruby. Ooh, that'd be cool. Go to shapeways.com, everyone. You can 3D print just like this place that you can do mugs and looking at my hands and t-shirts. But I used to okay, so here's the deal. You guys used to get your tools one at a time. I got mine, boom, we got ours. And then they'd say, get to work, kid. Make this. And I'd have all my friends drooling over my tools, and I was always so lonely because I worked so many hours working for a jewelry store, so I would invite all my friends over and use my tools. So we would go into this garage that somebody set up, and it was craft center, and I would invite them over, and I'd bring my bags and bags of tools, sit down, and everybody would use the tools, and I'd have buddies. And that's what I miss, is working with a bunch of jewelers. I really miss doing that. I wish I could get us all together and work together. Wish we could all work together, make money together, and play together. Well, thanks for joining, everyone. This is just one of those I wanted to do. You're in. I'm in. Yay, we have Cafacer here. Thanks for joining. I'm in. I love working in groups of people. I love working with people. I love working, sitting down, and all that creative energy and juices. Oh, that'd be so fun. You get to have it. You have a couple people working for you. One now. Oh, it must feel weird only having one person work next to you instead of two. So, I love working with people. So, now here's another thing. Okay, so everybody's going to... So these guys would get one tool at a time. And this is what I wanted to pass on to Drenis. Is that later years from now, you'll look back on it and you'll think, oh my gosh, that was such a terrible tool, but it will be your most favorite tool. Do you remember that, Ginger and Terry? I have these tools that are the worst. Uh-huh. Ginger and you need to scope from the... Oh, yes. You guys are close. Aren't you, Ginger? You're in the same... You guys could get together. Can you do it together? That'd be fun. Or you might be busy. You'll have to do it... lunchtime or something. And so you'll look at your tool that you first got. Yeah, let's do it. She is. I want to be part of it. So when you guys do it, I'm going to get on the chat. I've set it up so I can get on your streams now, you guys. Except Ginger, you did yours at 8 o'clock, which is 8, 7, 6, 5, 5 o'clock my time in the morning. You have to think 3 hours difference. What time did you stream this morning, Ginger? Hi, Berry Red. How are you doing? I'm Shoshana. How are you doing? What time did you scope this morning? I mean, I watched it afterwards. I've been getting into my shop, setting up my computer. Hola, good? Uh-huh, you did three today, and I was so excited. I hope you do three tomorrow. I hope you do. I mean, it's so cool. And your daughter's gorgeous. Gorgeous? Darling, you make gorgeous kids. Hi, how are you? We've got Ebsty69. How are you doing? I'm Shoshana. I am an artist, a jeweler, a musician, a coffee drinker. I have a bunch of friends on here. First one was early at 8, 7, 6, 5. It was 5 o'clock my time. I was sleeping. I just found a bunch of sea glass in the Kodiak. Alaska, you can't wait to use it. Oh, my gosh. I used to live in Cordova, Alaska. Mario Girl 13. You are... Oh, I'm going to follow you. Are you living in Alaska now? Mario, are you living in Alaska, or did you go up there for a little trip to get the sea glass? Kodiak. They have big bears up there. So yeah, I can't wait to do the scopes at my bench. So I've set it up so that I can watch everybody's stream while I'm working and talk every once in a while. and that I can stream from my thing. I will have it mostly on my bench, and I'm not going to use regular tools. I'm just going to show people how DIY, do it yourself, how you can create your own stuff and, you know, just makeshift. So it's going to be interesting because I'm going to get a lot of newbies on. They're going to think that I'm not qualified because I'm not looking through my tools. Hi. How are you doing? Went for a spiritual healing? Ooh. You might want to put a picture on there because you've got some cool things to talk about. And if you have a picture, people will take you seriously. It's easy. You can get out, put anything up, and then and go back on with a picture. I followed you. What was I saying? About, so this is going to be interesting. Wink, wink. So, Terry, I'm really glad you did a stream. I think you could even market your hand. Oh, do you have a bad connection? Excuse me. You're going to have to watch on, yeah, profile information. You're going to have to watch Drenna's on replay because we're going to talk, I talked about hammers. Oh, well, you heard it. So, you do? I've made jewelry out of slate, black slate. In fact, I looked up in the olden days, like in BC, before Christ, what kind of jewelry they made, and they carved out of wood. Slate is really cool. And there were a lot of talismans back then, and I would carve these shapes, and then I would put them on ropes and so forth, and they were one of my better sellers. There was this, like, prosperity shape that I carved, and a warrior shape that I carved, and... Yeah, I had to wear, yay, I had to, my mentor, yes, I have decided I am going to, I have named Drenna's my, I don't know if I should say it right now, let me finish my story, is that slate is not good for your lungs, so I would have to wear a lot of masks, and I would literally carve with my little flex shaft, and these shapes and so forth. We're all, Ginger's on here. She's one of my faves. You guys are my faves. Terry's my fave. I've got a lot of my faves on here, you guys. And I'm copying the word that Ginger used to use. Ooh, will you send me an elephant shaped from slate? That would be cool. Elephants stand for a lot. Yeah. And on the slate, it's really bad for your lungs, so make sure you cover your mouth. And what I would do, because it would still get through all of my gear and so forth, good preparation for jewelry show over in Melbourne. Ooh, good preparing for it. Yeah, so I used to take, with the club I told you about, oh, really? That's so cool. That is so cool. What's up, Grandma? I am talking about jewelry. Oh, hearts. Yay. And how to carve slate. That's what's up. And so I would take a, you know how olden day grandmas and grandpas used to have these handkerchiefs, very thin. Gone. Okay, they used to have these handkerchiefs made out of really fine cotton, and they're very thin. They're very tightly woven. I would dip it in water, wring it out, and then I would put it like a little bandana around me, and it would catch all the slate, that the dust, the fine dust, underneath my mask, and that way I didn't inhale all the slate. Oh, I know. I love them. They're so soft. I bet you did this too. I used to make little dollies out of them for my two daughters when they were little girls. Vintage hankies. Vintage hankies, yes. And some have tatting around the edge. Oh, I learned how to tat, all that stuff. They work the best to keep that really fine dust out. Yeah, little baby dolls. I used to tie them often. You told Neo about the club that he could join. Oh, I remember that. Are you going to take him? Are you going to take him to that club? Yeah. And slate, people like it. Okay, when I'm done with it, what I used to do is take butcher's wax, or you can take beeswax, and I would take tatting. I know, but it's like a meditating thing. Tat, 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 tat. I'd go to these grandma's houses and sit with them when I was a little kid and tat with them. I just loved it. So I would take these slates and then I would wipe them down and wash them off and then put them out in the sun to dry off or underneath a lamp. And then I would take butcher's wax. Oh, he does. That's right. You can't take him. You're going to take it about talking about the club. Did you give him the message of where the club is? Oh, yes. Yes. Tatting bobbins. Oh, November. You told me about it. And so then I take butcher's wax and I would rub it on to the slate. And then I would take some mineral spirits, kind of like either mineral spirits or I would take, alcohol. And then I would wipe it down with alcohol. So I'd put the wax on the slate and then take alcohol and rub it down and go Drenas. And I then would take Central Florida. Ooh, I know. Drenas, tell them about the workshop. It sounds so interesting. I wish I could go. I want to go. I want to do what you guys are doing. Feeling left out. Fobob? Is that what it is? Bob? What's the topic? Yeah, wait till you hear the topic. Oh, you have a bad connection? I keep dropping my phone. I'm sorry. Another thing I used to put on my slate while you guys are talking. I know it. I love enameling. I love enameling. Ginger, have you ever tried the enameling? Oh, good. Stitching blades connection's good. At least we have one. That's good. I think he's going to a kiln fired. Ginger, have you ever tried the... I forgot the name. I've never been great with names on all the jewelry stuff. I can do it all, but I forget the names real quick. It's the enameling with no backing. All right. You didn't get a... I'm sorry about that, Diana. It's one of those things. They're having problems with the notifications. I know I want to go to the enameling. All right. Everybody on here, what is the name of the enameling without the back? They just put on a thin film and then the enamel it, and it so they have a hole like this and they drip. That's it. That's what I want to learn how to do. I want to learn how to do that. Plique azure. Plique azure. That's what I want to learn how to do. I really want to learn how to do that. I've heard it's really difficult. I have done cloisonné. I have done regular enameling. You have no idea how excited I am. You told me about the slate. Thanks. Oh, Kodiak is full. Here's another thing I did with a slate. This sold really well because when I lived in Cordova, I sold a lot of jewelry. The fishermen, you know how it is up there. Oh, well, you're not from there. Magnificent. Okay, so the slate. You can draw with chalk on slate. And, of course, we all know that. And then, so you can do these little drawings. So let's say I made a little piece about this big. And what shape sold wonderfully well in slate is you take a donut and you make it half round and you put it on a chain. So you don't put a jump ring or anything. You use it like a jump ring. You just stick it on there. So it's just hanging like that. And I would draw these little paintings. I would take like liquid, I would turn my chalk to liquid paint. And then I'd paint these little things. And then I would take and spray it with a sealer. A clear sealer, and it can be anything. The first thing I always did was, it sounds crazy, but I would use hairspray. You don't need to use hairspray. You can use something better than that. And then I would paint it over with some kind of a sealer, and that would sell really well. Would I wear it now? Probably not. But back then, everybody wanted a little painting on the slate. Another thing I did with the slate that was really good. Well, thank you everybody for joining. That so cool. They use picture to make miniature stained glass windows. Oh, do they really? Oh, I've never seen that. That is so cool. This is so cool. I get to find out so many cool things that I don't know about. You know, I love learning. I know. Diana, I'm glad you got on here. But Periscope has been having problems with notifications. They're trying to fix it. That is, yeah. So I want to, so on the slate, the other thing I used to do is that, they do very well. Is that on my slate pieces, what I then started doing is that I did a lot of silver work, is that I would grind slate to make it three-dimensional, so it would kind of look like mountains, like a relief of a mountain. And then I would set it in sterling, and I would cut the backs out so you could see through the back. And I would leave it frosty. The slate would be frosty, but I would make my silver very shiny. And I would make sure that I would put silver over the slate, and I would, I loved working with slate. It was fun, but it does crack really easily. So you need, what I would do in the back is I would take cardboard, or not cardboard, some kind of poster board. No, not poster board, mat board. And I would soak it in really hot molten wax, and then I would put it underneath the slate. We've got one Tahawe. Welcome. And it's like, it's kind of cheating, but it would still be kind of moist, and I would set the stone in, squish it in, and then I would set it, and when it got squashed in and dried and cooled off, the wax, of course, was stuck into the slate. You're watching YouTube about cold and hot connections. Good. I love that. And I would then set it with that hot mat board soaked wax, lukewarm. And then when I would set it, it would squish it down in. And after it cooled off, the wax would hold it in and it wouldn't rattle. And if it did drop, it had a cushion and it wouldn't break as quickly. That's what I learned. Because I used to guarantee my pieces 100%, and if anything came back broken, I had to replace it. And so I learned how to make things so they wouldn't break, because I didn't want to keep replacing them. Talk to me, guys. I'm done talking. Slate sounds scary. Slate. So, Drenis, are you going to do any other? Yeah. I learned that trick from opals. You know how they used to do doublets, is what they, or triplets, they'd call opals. They would glue a nice opal top with a back black or a bad opal on the bottom, and then they would set wax in the back of the opal to keep it looking nice and opal-y like. Snickers 0342, welcome. Every time I had to repair opals and I'd have to unset the stones, I'd find all this junk underneath and I'd have to put it all back. What were I saying about my heart and hand? Oh, this is what I... Doublets. Yes, doublets and triplets. Remember those? Do they even sell them more? You know what I'd do? I would market it to the Periscope people. So if you go to shapeways.com, or sawdust behind the stones. Absolutely, I remember that. See, ginger has repaired a lot of stuff. They are so delicate. There are ways to set it so they're protected. I would go to shapeways.com, make an account. It's free to make an account. And they do 3D printing, and they can make jewelry for you. They'll tell you how to do it for nothing, and you don't pay them until they sell. You're looking for a stump. Yes, that will call my name and say me in the forging. Sir Neo. Sawdust, paper, cootie. They do metal. They do every kind. Gold, silver, brass, bronze, all the kinds. Aluminum. Everyone, check it out. I mean, it's expensive to get the first one, but then when you get the first one done, you can send it off to Ginger, who does casting. Pay her to cast your items up, or some casting company, and they can then cast off, make a mold and cast all the rest. I tell people to go to Shapeways all the time to do their prototypes, and it works great. It's just a little pricey in the very first one, but after that, find another way to do it. So the material behind to act as a buffer, sort of, yes, and also sometimes on some of the softer stones that are clear, like moonstones. I used to find a lot of moonstones that had black or a gold or a silver lining. Sometimes people put aluminum behind a moonstone and then set it, and a stabilizer, yeah. And you would see this iridescent look underneath the moonstone. It was either silver or gold. Some people painted colors like enamel for your fingernails. I've unset stones and found paper painted with enamel, and you could see the colors through the back of the stone. Wow, Recept Demerta 18. Welcome. What else? Let's talk about. Okay, got. Oh, stumps. You guys, how do we get Drenis a stump? What about sea glass? Is it easy to drill through a hole? All right. Who here has drilled sea glass? I have not. I do have some diamond burrs that have diamond grit embedded into the burr, and I would guess you could drill through it. I've never drilled through sea glass. Who has drilled through sea glass? You have seen the people come and soak opals in water. Drilling sea glass also sounds scary. It's not. Whatever is behind the translucent stone will affect. Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, I've never drilled through glass. Has anybody drilled through it? Okay. How do you do it? I'm sorry. I'm supposed to be the expert. I don't know how to do it. Ginger does. What do you use to drill through it? Yay, Ginger Allen's the rock star. I love you guys. This is fun. Underwater. Not oil. Done stained glass. Oh, cool. My daughters have done stained glass. Okay, so why would you put underwater instead of oil? Does it matter? I put mine under oil. I put oil there. Water, high speed. Got it. Well, wow, why is he so scared of natural products from the earth? He's not. He's goofing off. Drenis is, he's a macho man. He's just goofing with us. He's always goofing. You got to beware. Isn't he, Ginger? He's always goofing. He gets me to do things. What does water keep cool? Like tile saw? I guess the water keeps. I'm guessing it keeps. She knows what she's talking about. Oil is really overkill. Well, that's good to know. She knows her stuff, guys. Follow her. Follow her, follow her, follow her. She has cool tools in her studio. I love her bench. I want her bench. I want your shop, Ginger. Let's trade. You use water to grind the edges of glass. Okay. I have a question. Is glass from a car different than other glass? I think it is. Like this Porsche has some cracks on the edge of one of the windows, and I wanted to take sandpaper and just sand it down so it wasn't so sharp. Hi, everyone. You can't wait to make joy from sea glass. Yes, it is different. Okay, so I can't take sandpaper to my Porsche window that has little cracks. I think someone tried to break it and just cracked a little spot. I want to like make it not so sharp. It's tempered. Okay, that's what I thought. It's 1990. I'm sure back then they were making those too. Hello, how are you doing? So I'm Shoshana Klisky, and I'm from Northern California, and we're talking. We have a bunch of artists in here and jewelers and crafters and designers, and we're all talking about how to do things. Stitch and blade. Have no fear. Okay, I was gonna try that. Yeah, I was gonna try that. I have some really thick emery paper, really thick paper. You know those sanders, those round sanders, those, what do they call them? Oh, I'm terrible with names. You know, let me tell you a little secret. I'm so bad with names, it must be wet. It's the kind that has a round thing that you just slide on and you turn on and it goes. Orbital sanders? No. What's it called? Tube sanders? No. It's got a tube that sandpaper that you stick on. Belt sanders, that's it. Thanders. I like that. Belt thanders. Those belt danders, sanders, have the tube sandpaper that comes in really thick paper. I use a lot, they come in different grits. I use those because the paper is so thick on those they don't rip. I just cut them out. I don't put them on the belt sanders or whatever you call them. It's great sandpaper, it doesn't rip. Here's a story, it's true. I'm embarrassed to say, but it's true. I'm terrible with names. Terrible. You love grits. I love grits. Yeah. Too coarse for my. I can get finer grits in those though. You need a race belt sander. When I was a little. Used to race belt sanders? No way. Okay, so I'm so bad with names. I had my firstborn. I was struggling for a name. Everybody was telling me what they thought. I had a name picked out. I worked really hard. My whole family and I, we all figured out ground, stone ground are the best. Oh no. And then they'd plug them in. How dangerous is that? They had to have a long extension cord. So when Sarah was born, the minute moment she was born, they said, "What's your baby's name?" I belted out a completely different name. I know it does sound dangerous, doesn't it? You didn't say it was safe. I know it's not. Can you imagine? What were they thinking, Dredis? You're a little baby. We're working hard, we're goofing off. Boys and power toys. I know. So when Sarah was born, I just belted out the name that I didn't even have on my list. Second story. My littlest was going to be born. I had everybody helping me again, the whole family, the whole thing, and I couldn't come up with a name. So I gave Sarah, my oldest, the gift to name her sister. So she came up with a name. Hey, Brazil. Hola. We speak English here. How are you doing? I'm Shoshana, and I'm in Northern California. We're talking tools. So I told my oldest daughter that she could name her sister. I am so bad with names. I use all these tools. I forget the names of the tools. I use them. I like that name, Dollface 50. Aw, Dollface. I'm going to call all my Perry loves, all you guys. Ginger, you're a Dollface. Terry, you're a Dollface. Drenis, you're a Dollface. Who else is on here? Cheryl, you're a Dollface. Mystic is a Dollface. Typically didn't name their babies about a year. Are you kidding? Wow. That's a long time. What did they call them? For a whole year, what did they call them? Dollface. They could have called them Dollface. I like that name. ADV. Wow, that's an interesting name. Thank you for joining. Bet you they jump right off. Well, you guys, I'm thinking of ending this pretty soon. And what time is it? So many died young. No, that's terrible. Steel and pickle. All right. You didn't get. Oh, for 2 days? Oh, see, I'm not the only one then. It is a big responsibility. Yeah. But even in my studio, a tool that I've used over 35 years, not a good pair. I've used tools for like 25, 30 years, and I still can't remember the names of the tools. As baby? Aw. Hey, baby. I like that. Oh, Drenis. Ginger, Drenis got a bunch of books. Can you remember any of the names of the books, Drenis? We've inspired him, guys. Drenis is going to be a jeweler before we know it. He's going to be making money hand over fist. He's going to beat us all. Mama said she had to get to know me first. 2 days? Wow. And Drenis, 2-in-1 jewelry book. Lab work jewelry book. Oh, cool. Cool. I haven't seen that one. I have to tell you guys a trick. If you don't want to buy a book, you can go to your library and you can tell them the ISBN number. And if it's on Amazon, your library will buy it for you, for the library. And they usually get used books for $2 or $3. Oh my gosh. Yeah. And so when you call up the library and tell them that you do they have that book, and if it's on Amazon, you give them the ISBN. The library will buy the book. They'll ship it directly to your house, and then you can use it. And then you give it to the library, and it's in the. I know. No, you can't put steel in pickle. No, you can't put steel in pickle. You can't. Steel. It'll wreck it. All right, back me up on this one. Ginger, I have never heard that you could put. Well, it depends on what pickle. What pickle, Dennis? You can't. See? Two. You can't put steel in. The book said that? I wonder what kind of pickle they're talking about, Ginger. Some pickles will do steel, but it's not the ones for silver. I wonder what ones they said in the book. Miss Ole. Welcome. We're talking about pickle now, which is a chemical. I know, yes, yes, you keep it out. Dill pickles. It might be a different pickle. There are some for just steel, but not for silver. Dill pickle. I actually watched a YouTube that someone took pickle juice and did etching on a steel knife, a steel blade, and it worked. They used a battery charger, pickle juice. What's the talk about? We are jewelers, artists, craftspeople. We're talking about what can we do in the jewelry studio or the metalsmithing studio or art studio. I've watched a lot of knife makers drop their steel into different pickles. I just don't know what the pickle bath, what the acid bath is that they're using. I know it's not the same as... It is. And they use vinegar, and they use salt and water. Steel in a... I know, it makes it a copper plating solution. If you want that, I don't like that. I hate that. Tell them. No steel. Pickle. Oh, here's a thing that I've watched you guys use. You use those cones to do... It's a bad thing. It is a bad thing. I never put steel in my pickle. I have 3 different pickle baths. I have one for silver, I have one for gold, and then I have one for just junk. And I have 2 different pickle baths for the silver and the gold. And then I use my icky pickle, the old pickle, for my junk stuff. Because I don't like tossing it until it's completely used. I know, it is a waste. And so, that's what I do. How many people here, when I'm soldering gold, and I don't throw it, and I want to quench it to make it work hard, soft, annealed, I don't throw it in water. I throw it into alcohol. How many people throw it into alcohol after you've soldered some gold and stuff? I throw it into alcohol, and it doesn't make it, it keeps it nice and clean. And it keeps, like if I want to keep it at the... Okay, so I've worked it up. Denatured, I do. Denatured. I throw it in an alcohol bath instead of water. Oh, the cops are coming in. They're coming in for coffee. Wine. Nope, I don't throw it in wine. That has sugar in it. That would make it dirty. I've always thrown my gold into alcohol. I've never really thought about putting it in water. It's like if I make it work hard and then I'm soldering it and I want to keep it nice and hard, I throw it into alcohol. It cools down slower. I've never used that. I use a blue flux. What a waste. I've seen people use that. Do you like it? You must love it. I use this. I buy this stuff. It's chemically. But I also wear these fluoride masks that cuts out all the fluorides because I know how fluoride is really bad for you. So I use a lot of masks. It's probably healthier for you than what I'm using. So, what I use for a mask to keep the fluorides out is an asbestos. You screw it on both of them. Asbestos masks also get rid of fluorides. It's a chemical that, that's what I use. You cook with wine, sometimes I even put it in food. Drinking it, cooking with it. Wine, there is a leather worker that I know that he puts his leather in wine. It is a good plan. He puts his leather in the wine and it makes it this texture. He takes it out and dries it and then he works with it. He swears by it. He says it gives it this beautiful sheen and he can tool it and make it look gorgeous. Well, guys, I'm thinking I should end this. I have to go back home. I'm really glad that you're scoping. Scope again tomorrow, Ginger. You're going to scope 3 days. How come Andrew's not scoping? You guys? You do have an early morning. Man, I won't catch your early scope if you do it. I have to go. I've been turning my nights around. I used to stay up until around 4 or 5 in the morning and get up later, like 9 or so. But now I'm going to bed earlier, around 3 or 4, or 2 or 3. You'll scope at some point, great. Yeah. Nope, see this, you guys? Mimi is, in Turkish, it means boobs. So you delete that guy. Yeah, what I did, when can we meet, Ginger? Oh yeah, you guys, Asheville scopes. I've been to Asheville when I lived in Moravian Falls block. Yeah, anybody that from Turkey that says Mimi is saying boobs. Gotta block them. A lot of these other countries, I go back through and I put them in Google search, Google Translate to see what they're saying. And then I know what they're saying when they come up, most of them. So you guys have to do, I miss Asheville. Asheville's a great place, beautiful place. I'm talking like I live there. I don't, you guys know better than I do. So sorry. Okay, so I've got to go. Here's the old lady look. Well, here's another tip, you guys. Wild Man 3, Biltmore, put up the big tree today. Oh, Christmas trees, yay. It is a wonderful place. When I lived in Moravian Falls, it's a little dinky town of 300 or so. I owned some property there, and it must be Christmas. And I used to go to Ashland and Blowing Rock and all these other places. Oh, I loved it. I wish I was there. Loved it, loved it, loved it. So you guys scope. You have to scope together, and then I'm going to watch and talk to you guys. Eat some chocolate. All right, well, I got to get going. Ah, yes. Thanks for being on here, you guys. Love you all. I'll talk to you again. And tomorrow, we'll get the Porsche out of the way so I can do... It'll be fun. Yeah, it'll be fun. You guys scope together, eat some chocolate, and then I get to talk to you guys. Bye, everyone. Good night, Diana. Good night, Drenis. Good night, everyone. Ginger, good night. Terry, good night. Stitch and Blade and Oak Studio and Cheryl and Blue Radish. Blue Radish, we're leaving. Bye. And this person I just joined... Peace and love. Talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.